again. Let's see. Well, I'm gonna right, I'm gonna try and sort the silver screen out now. It shouldn't take so much effort though. At least I know what size to scale it down by, which is 40%. I'll try again with this one. I won't be needing to print this out though, so what I'll do is I'll just create a PDF of this. Alright, let's see. So I want the silk screen for the top part of the board. So the layers, I can turn off the layers that I don't want. Top silk screen, I want turn all that off. Basically it's just this. So anyway, I'll put that back, I'll just leave it off for now. I'll go to print and I want to put this in PDF. I'm going to put it all black and I want rid of that top silk screen, board outline as well, I need to mirror that. I don't want to rotate it. So I'll do this, I'll save it as a PDF and then I can export that as a hopefully it won't be the wrong size. It probably will be. That's the trouble when you print out to a document. It always ends up being the wrong size. Let's see if I can zoom in a bit. Right, it's mirrored, so it needs to be reversed. It has to be reversed so that when you laminate it on, it's actually the right way around. Okay, so I'll save that. Just a little screen I want. Try this. Oh, chips there. Right, I'm just going to see if I can open this with my other program and export it as a PNG, and hopefully I won't lose the resolution. Right, so I'll get out of that. I need a browser window open. Flipping Explorer. I think I need to put my computer back on high. Just a minute. Might have crashed because I'm not using my swaddling my CPU up. Right. See if I can export this. That's this little screen. Right, if I open that with it doesn't give you an option to save it as an image, that's the problem. Which is annoying. I think it's not in here. Blimey, neck, hang on a minute. Brother, where's brother? There we go, brother. That's my printer. Damn it, it's not. I can't find it. Where the hell is it? Stop it. It must be down here. ScanSoft paper pot. That's what I'm looking for. So it's in ScanSoft. Must be it. I'll try that. Hopefully I'm not going to lose resolution sizes. I just hope it hasn't upsized it, because that's what causes the problem. Where is it? Should be in here. I'm getting these stupid trial messages coming up now, which is annoying. Hi, Truff, as well. Hi. God, I'm just going to drag it in there. Can't see it. There it is. Right, save as. I want to save it as a PNG. Let's see, there we go. PNG. I hope it hasn't stuck a bloody watermark on it. I'll be really annoyed if it has. Oh, cool. No bloody watermark. That's brilliant. It saved it as a PNG. Right, let's open it with... now I can open it. There's a paint shop program, so a file. Now I don't know what's, let's see what size it is. Print preview. Hang on. It's taking a full A4 sheet by the looks of it. And that's, I don't want that. What the hell is wrong with this? This is what happens. It's upsized it to A4 and I don't want it in an A4 size. Oh, it's unfit to page, maybe that's why. Let's just try this. Original size, hold on. Grayscale. still, oh, it's at 255. Oh, there's no wonder it's 100%. That's it, that's what I want, 100%. That's the right size. Right, okay. Now, there's something wrong with it though. Right, I can get rid of this now because I've already got the file. Alright, so I need to copy that. Open my A4 sheet. Let's see, where is it? I'll open that JPG because that was dodgy anyway. I've got a PNG of that now, so should have timed out again. I can wipe that because that's the PNG. Oh, sorry, the JPEG. I mean, right, now copy that one, and this time, look, it hasn't messed it up. It still kept the resolution. So I'll copy that. Make sure I have. Right. Paste. New selection. Oh good, it's done it right. So stick that one there. This is what I was trying to do last time, but it went and my border's missing as well. Hang on a minute, I need my outline border. Just a minute, go back a minute. It's not, I haven't got the outline border there. I need that as well. For some reason it's not doing it. Oh, it is there. Oh, bloody hell. Just the resolution didn't show up. Right. That one. Good. Yeah, that's good. Right. I need to move that a little bit. I just want to get it centered. Now, if only you'd done this last time, I wouldn't have had all that messing around to do. I might actually do it again actually, and now I've figured it out. I could do the circuit board again, but I think it's good enough to print it actually. I think I've fixed it enough. I actually corrected a few things with the holes as well, which are easy to do. Right, so let's just print preview. Why is it looking so big? I mean, so small. It should be, it should take up. that should take up a full A4 sheet. It's buggering me about. Sheet A4. That should be taking up a full sheet. Now if we put that bit to page, then is that the right, that should be the right size. Oh, that's what the problem is. These settings here were messed up. Right, I'm gonna do a test print of that. It's gone all the way to the bottom now. What's wrong with it? I don't believe this. Move that back up a bit. Print preview. Okay, that looks right. It's too far to the right though. That's better. It's put it at 185% now, look. What the hell's wrong with this thing? It's a scale of 185, what? Should be 1:1. Well, I'm just going to have to do a test print, see what it looks like. Hopefully it'll be the right size. I hate these things. Printers are such a pain in the ass, aren't they? Well, they change the resolution sizes, so you don't want them changing. That looks like it's going to be too big though, because based on the actual board that I printed out earlier, it should not be that big. It should be a lot smaller than that. Paper, normal. Scaling's off. it's when you change the resolution, it makes all the lines blocky, and that's the problem I'm having. Yeah, it's way too big. It's way, way, way too big. I knew it was. Flipping thing. This is what goes on when you try to do multiples, it's always the problem. Now I'm basically going to have to change the size of the resolution again, and I don't want to be doing that. Let's look at the PDF again. That's the original one. It's not so bad going down in size though. It's I'll do this one, I can get an idea. Image, resize, oh, wrong one. Resize. Well, 41% is not right on this situation. I'm going to try 80% of original, because it looks like it's... Right, let's try, see if it's gone blocky again. Actually, it's not too bad. Right, let's just... See, you get the double lines, you get the grey lines. You get grey and with the black. That's the problem I'm having when you change the resolution. Oh. Print preview again. Actually, that looks about right. Center on page. See, that looks about right. Right, I have to print it and find out. Why is everyone so quiet today? It's like somebody died or something. Put my camera back on. Now this is what I've got. Where are we? This is the actual size that we want. This pattern. I think it's about right. So that's just going to show 80% reduction in size for these, and it was 40% reduction in size for the flipping PCB set, that went wrong anyway. But anyway, I did two or three before I got it right, but flipping printer was clogged up. Now it looks like I've got this the right size actually. I think that's going to be okay. So that's why I need the lines. Yeah, border lines are important because that's what gives me a reference as to the size. So if I cut one of these out, I can overlay it and look through it, shine some light through. Not that one though, because it's printed on both sides, but piece of cardboard. This one should. I'll cut these out now and see what's what. And then I've got to print it on the laser printer, and that's a different machine altogether. And I was going to hope that the resolution changes are the same. They should be. The tilt screen's not as critical though. It's not as, if it's slightly off by a millimetre or something, it's irrelevant really. It's blowing a gale outside, and it's weird because it's normally freezing cold when it's doing that, but this year it's like winter's late. Oh, and look at the coloured ones I did. it crashed before, so I didn't get a chance to see, but I did coloured ones. It makes it easy to see certain aspects of the board in, when you do it in different colours. It helps to show up any defects when you've got different coloured back. It just makes certain things stand out. Anyway, I've cut my outline for that. I'm going to cut the cardboard one out as well. That poor Schubert. I don't know how he managed to get a staple in his sock. I don't know how he managed to do that. Yeah, at least I've got some scrap bits of printout which I can use to test this. So I'm just going to cut this one out. This is what I have to do every time I want to make a circuit board, is basically do a test print on photo paper or ordinary paper. And the lamination is the final stage, which is fun, because I burn my fingers on it because it's so bloody hot. Right, let me just match the components up with this. Right, capacitors go on this side, so I actually have to put this on the back like that. Then I have to hold it up to the light and make sure that everything lines up. And actually, I'll put the camera on as well so you can see what I'm looking at. I mean, just a minute. My flipping stream's not working. Is my stream actually working? because my livestream's not working on the preview page. I don't know what's going on with it. Refresh that. There's something strange going on with YouTube. All my preview windows are giving me errors. Content encoding error. What the hell is going on with this preview page? Is anybody else having this problem? Anyway, I've been doing my silk screen for the circuit board. This is just a test print. It didn't come out so good, this one. It's good enough for doing an alignment test though. The flipping... what's going on? Content encoding error. The page you are trying to view can't be shown because it uses an invalid or unsupported form of compression. This is the first time I've had this message before. What the hell's going on? It was working before. This is new. Down a minute. What's going on with the preview page? Is anybody else having problems with it? The preview page is just full of errors. I have to refresh it again. I don't know what's going on. It's totally messed up. Well, I've got some of the videos back, but one of Russ's streams is still giving me the message. I don't know what's going on. This page seems fine. Okay, so let's put this up against the light. I'll see if you can get this. I'll see if I can get this to show you on the camera. Right, if I move the camera across here, it's going to be blinded by the light for a moment. I'm basically looking to put my silkscreen over the top. I'm recording this mainly because I want to be able to take some snapshots of it later because, oh, hang on a minute. What have I done now? Camera, I want camera back on. Right, camera, put this light up. Right, you should be able to see straight through at the pads behind it. The silk screen should show you, well, you can see the transistors, the diodes and resistors. There's the pads. Oh, the camera's too low again. Right. That's showing up. There's the resistors. I'll put that on top. It actually looks like it's bang on. Well, it's good enough. That's bang on. I think the camera's probably glaring a bit too much. Yeah, that's going to work really well. I think that light is too bright, so I'm going to move that away. Put the camera back over here. Goes in there. I'll get my other torch. Can't reach it. Other torch should be better. Oh, this is not as bright. This is a lot better. Oh, just a minute. Let me get this lined up. When you're playing around with lag, delays, it's really difficult to do anything right. Right, now, put the torch behind here. It shouldn't glare the camera so much. Show up on there. It's actually, it's a lot better, it's not too bright. I'm having to shine it through a piece of cardboard and a piece of paper, so it's not easy to do that. I think you could see. The component layout is this one. The tracks underneath. Get this lined up. Batteries are going in this torch. Oh my god, it's gone really flat. I need to go and put new batteries in here. I don't know if I've got any. Probably not. Anyway, this is going to work. I've got the sizes right. when you actually get printed out and you've got a physical representation in your hand, do you actually get to get a proper perspective on sizes and everything? And I left myself a lot of room for a heatsink actually, but yeah, luckily I've got the current consumption down so much that I don't really need any heatsinks right now. But at some point there's going to be room. There's going to be room to put a heatsink in this section, where this writing is. So it'll be actually between these two transistors here. These are the power transistors. So there's enough room there. And because these particular diodes are low profile, I mean they're going to be quite low down anyway, the transistors will be standing up quite a bit, so that's fine. Two capacitors down here. To get this, I need to clear this stuff away so I can get my laminator out. So I'm just going to try and attempt to save this screen this time, because last time it crashed and I don't know why it did that, but it didn't save nothing when that happened. So I'm just going to stop the stream for now, because I've got to clear this stuff away. Clear all my table, because I want to do, once I start doing the etching part, I don't want to have any corrosive stuff around this, all the circuitry stuff, you know what I mean? Okay, so be back shortly, hopefully. I've still got to print this out on the laser printer as well. I'll do that off camera, I think. But look at the one that came out that was massive. Look at that, huge. At least I've got a reference. It might be too big, but it's still useful for something. Yeah, I mean, why is everyone so quiet? Has war broken out or something?